Hi, I'm Li Hao. So you've seen how we can create custom stores in Svelte out of popular state management libraries such as Redux, State Machine Xstate, Veltio, and you've seen how we can create an immutable store using RxJS. And there's one library, although it's not entirely like a state management library, but it has helped us with a lot of event streaming. Which is RxJS. So today I'm going to take a look at how we can use RxJS as a store in Svelte application. So I'm actually very new to RxJS, and in fact, I haven't really used RxJS before. Prior to this recording this video, I have done my research solely because of this video, because I know some of you have been using RxJS and wanted to see how you can use RxJS with Svelte. If I do anything wrong, please comment down below and let me know about it. Okay, thank you. So RxJS. So RxJS provides us like observables that you can subscribe to and get the value out of the observables. And that actually, the concept of that's actually very similar to Svelte Store, where you can subscribe to the store and get the value of the store. And you can subscribe from it. So if you take a look at Observable and the store contract, you'll notice that Observable actually kind of follows the Svelte store contract. So what that means is that if you have an Observable, you can use the dollar prefix value variable syntax to access the value of the values that's being generated out of the Observable. So let me show you an example. Over here, I have a REPL. So now I want to create an observable using from event. So from event allows us to create observable from an event listener. So I'm import from RxJS, and over here I'm going to create a mouse position observable. So over here I use from event, say document, and then listens the mouse move event from document, and immediately if I do something like this, mouse position, immediately I can already get the value, all the events from mouse move observable. So it's mouse event, but there's nothing, it's like the event itself. So if you want to actually get the client X and client Y of the mouse move event, we'll have to pipe it through RxJS operators to maybe pick up some X and Y position, right, from the event. So for each of the events, I'm gonna call map. So map is an operator from RxJS. I'm pretty new to this. I've tried to do my best on researching this. If I'm doing something wrong, let me know in the comments, right? So RxJS operators. So I'm using map and from, and I need to map the events to maybe an object. So I'm gonna say X is events.client X, Y is event.client Y. So I pipe this event to the mouse position, and now let's try and see what happens. Come over here, okay, object. So I'm gonna say instead, I'm gonna say JSON stringify to see the mouse position. So when I move around, you can see immediately that this is like a store. You can subscribe to it, and it also returns a subscribe unsubscribe method that you can unsubscribe from the store. So basically, it works out of the box, right? What about using RxJS with Svelte? It just works out of the box. You can use it immediately. So you've seen how we can convert an observable to a Svelte store. Basically not really convert, because observable has already implemented the Svelte store contract. So you can use it like a Svelte store using the dollar prefix syntax to automatically subscribes and unsubscribe from it and get the value of out of the observable events. But now we're gonna look at a flip side of it. For example, if you have a Svelte store, can you convert that to become an observable? Well, of course, the answer is yes. I'm going to roughly show you how I would do it. Again, disclaimer, this is my first time doing this. If you have a better way of doing it or better API that I don't know of, let me know, comments down below. Right, so here I'm going to say from, I have a defined function called toObservable. And it should take in a store, and I'm going to return a new, return an observable. So I can create a new observable using the constructor observable. And for each of the observer, we need to subscribe from the store. And for each of the value coming out from the store, we are going to call observer.next with the value. So I think I need to return this unsubscribe method. So so the observable can be unsubscribed from it as well. Should return an unsubscribe method if you can from each of the observer. So I can convert a store to observable, right? So here I've created a store using a mouse position. It's the same event, but it's creating a new readable store, which is a custom. So we can create a custom Svelte store out of the mouse position. You should watch the video on how I created this. Links in the description below. So over here, I'm going to import that mouse position store. And actually, over here, I also need to know that I need to import this observable, right? So over here, I'm going to... I have my mouse position as a store. Okay, mouse position store. I would to create observable out of it. I probably will have to call observable the store, and since it's observable, we can subscribe to it and take a look at the value out of it. All right, so here I'm gonna say value console log value. So this is now an observable. We can see the value out of it. And to prove that this is already an observable, we're going to use pipe, like one of the RxJS operator again over here. So I'm going to say pipe it to say, this time around I'm going to use a new operator called pluck. So I can just pick one value out of the object. So this object, the store gives us X and Y value. So here I'm going to pluck just the X. So if I move around, you'll see that only the X value. Oh, I think I forgot to unsubscribe. That's why you can see the console log again. So let me refresh this. Whoops. Yep. So you can see that the X value is coming out from the console. So here over here, I am going to... So this is like the X... observable using, I'm gonna say X dollar, and I'm gonna create another observable called Y dollar equals to two observable mouse position store dot pipe, and you can pluck just the Y property. And finally, we are maybe going to create a new observable by zipping these two observable into one. I'm gonna say sum of X and Y equals to zip maybe X and Y and pipe it. So I'm gonna use map again. Over here I will become an array of X value and Y value, and I am going to return the sum of both, so X plus Y. So again, these are all observables, right? To prove that this is observable, you can do all the operators from observable from RxJS. So finally, this is an observable, which means it follows a store contract and you can still subscribe to it. So here I am going to say sum of X and Y. So as I move along, you can see that over here, you can see the sum of X and Y being shown over here, right? So that's all for RxJS with Svelte store. You can this RxJS Observable is already following the Svelte store contract, which means that you can already subscribe automatically subscribes from it using a dollar prefix variable syntax. And it's and also actually they, we can also in this video I've showed you how you can convert a store to come observable so that you can play around using all the observable RxJS operators to play around with all those events, and then finally because it is a store you can use it directly again. So instead of, you know, coming out with your own derive and deriving like custom store deriving a store from your existing store, you can convert it to RxJS. Maybe it's easier for you to play around with it using all the RxJS operators, and then finally it is still following a store contract, so although essentially it's observable, but you can still subscribe it like a store, right? So let me know any good use case that you are doing with using RxJS with your with Svelte. Comments your REPL link in the description box. I will take a look all of them. And as always, if you like this video, give me a thumbs up. And if you haven't unsubscribed to my subscribed to my channel, be like a star, subscribe to my channel so that you get notified whenever the next video is out. So see ya, bye bye.